वेलकम। आजचा आपला जो विषय आहे तर महाराष्ट्र कृषी सेवा गट अ व ब त्याची पूर्व आणि मुख्य परीक्षा त्याच्या सिलेबस बद्दल आपण थोडीशी चर्चा करणार आहोत। इथं तर यामध्ये महाराष्ट्र कृषी सेवा, महाराष्ट्र ॲग्रिकल्चरल ॲग्रिकल्चर सर्व्हिसेस ग्रुप ए अँड बी या पदांसाठी वेगळी परीक्षा घेतली जाते MPSC मार्फत, आणि त्यामध्ये सुद्धा तीन टप्पे असतात प्रमुख, ज्यामध्ये पहिली पूर्वपरीक्षा 200 गुणांची, मुख्य परीक्षा 400 गुणांची आणि मुलाखत 50 गुणांची। तर याचं स्वरूप आपण बघू, महाराष्ट्र कृषी सेवा पूर्वपरीक्षेचं। तर याची जी परीक्षेची योजना आहे, तर यामध्ये विषय त्यांचा संकेतांक एकच आहे, यामध्ये पेपर एकच होतो एका तासासाठी, पण प्रत्येक विषयाचा जो वाटा आहे यामध्ये, तर मराठी विषयासाठी 15 प्रश्नसंख्या असेल ज्याला 30 गुण असतील, नंतर इंग्लिश 15 प्रश्नसंख्या आणि 30 गुण, म्हणजे प्रत्येक प्रश्न हा 2 गुणांसाठी इथं आपल्याला इथं उत्तर द्यायचं आहे। मराठीचा जो विषयाचा जो पेपर असेल किंवा जे प्रश्न असतील 15, त्याचा दर्जा शालांत म्हणजे 10वीपर्यंत आपलं जे आहे त्याचं जे मराठी आहे त्यापैकी शालांत, आणि त्याचं माध्यम मराठीच असणार आहे। इंग्लिशचा दर्जा पदवीचा, माध्यम इंग्रजी, आणि नंतर जे आहे जनरल स्टडीज सामान्य अध्ययन, तर याचे प्रश्न असतील 45। काल आपण याच्या संदर्भात चर्चा केली होती राज्यसेवा मुख्य परीक्षेच्या सिलेबस संदर्भात, तर तशाच पद्धतीचा अभ्यास या जनरल स्टडीजमध्ये आपल्याला इथं करावा लागणार आहे। हे 45 जे प्रश्न आहेत त्यांची उत्तरं देण्यासाठी त्याला गुण आहेत 90, दर्जा पदवी, याचं माध्यम इंग्रजी व मराठी दोन्हीमध्ये दोन्ही भाषांमध्ये याचे प्रश्न विचारलेले असतील, आणि कृषी विषयक घटक, आता हा बेसिक आपला ॲग्रिकल्चरचा विषय, याचे प्रश्न असतील 25 आणि याला 50 गुण असतील। पदवीचा BSc ॲग्री डिग्रीचे जे काही दर्जा आपण म्हणू त्यात आपल्याला त्याचे प्रश्न असतील, आणि याचं माध्यम मराठी किंवा इंग्रजीमध्ये। कालावधी 1 तासाचा आणि प्रश्नपत्रिकेचं स्वरूप वस्तुनिष्ठ बहुपर्यायी, म्हणजे आपल्याला ऑब्जेक्टिव्ह टाईप, इथं प्रश्न आले मल्टिपल चॉईसचे आणि तिथं आपण ते उत्तरं द्यायचे। तर याचा अभ्यासक्रम बघूया। आता प्री एक्झाम, पूर्वपरीक्षा, पूर्वपरीक्षेमध्ये आपल्याला जनरल स्टडीज, इंग्लिश आणि मराठी, ॲग्रिकल्चरच्या व्यतिरिक्त या 3 गोष्टींचा चांगल्यापैकी इथं अभ्यास करावा लागणार आहे। तर मराठीमध्ये सर्वसामान्य शब्दसमूह, त्यातील वाक्यरचना, त्यात असलेलं व्याकरण, म्हणी व वाक्प्रचार, याचा अर्थ, उपयोग आणि उतार्यांवरील प्रश्नांची उत्तरे, हा जनरल पॅटर्न मराठीमध्ये आपलं जे काही पुस्तकं शाळेचे आहेत त्यामध्ये ज्या गोष्टी असतील त्यामध्ये दिलेल्या, त्यातलं जे काही व्याकरण आहे ते सर्व व्याकरण इथं आपल्याला वापर करायचा आहे। त्यानंतर इंग्लिशमध्ये इंग्लिश लँग्वेज, कॉमन वोकॅबलरी, सेंटेन्स स्ट्रक्चर, ग्रामर, यूज ऑफ इडियम्स अँड फ्रेजेस अँड देअर मीनिंग अँड कॉम्प्रिहेन्शन ऑफ पॅसेज। सो मराठी आणि इंग्लिशचं कंटेंट तेच, फक्त भाषा वेगवेगळी। नंतर जनरल स्टडीज, आता या जनरल स्टडीजमध्ये सर्व गोष्टी आपल्याला इथं अभ्यासाव्या लागतील. आपलं सामान्य ज्ञान पूर्णपणे इथं टेस्ट होणार आहे. तर करंट इव्हेंट्स ऑफ नॅशनल अँड इंटरनॅशनल इम्पॉर्टन्स, चालू घडामोडी, राष्ट्रीय आणि आंतरराष्ट्रीय महत्त्वाचे ज्या असतात त्या सर्व आपण इथं सांगायच्या आहेत किंवा याचा अभ्यास ठेवायचा आहे. त्यासाठी जे काही घडतं आहे आसपास रोज त्याबद्दलची माहिती सुरुवातीपासून चांगल्यापैकी तयारी ठेवायची. त्यानंतर हिस्ट्री ऑफ मॉडर्न इंडिया विथ स्पेशल रेफरन्स टू महाराष्ट्र. आता मॉडर्न इंडियाचा इतिहास म्हणजे 1857 जो उठाव झाला त्यानंतर पासून तर आत्तापर्यंतचा इतिहास त्याचा अभ्यास ठेवून इथं उत्तरं आपल्याला देता येतात विथ स्पेशल रेफरन्स टू महाराष्ट्र. महाराष्ट्रात काय घडामोडी झाल्या त्या संदर्भातली माहिती इथं आवश्यक आहे. इतिहासाचा भाग झाला हा. त्यानंतर ज्योग्राफी, आपला भूगोल भारताचा तसंच महाराष्ट्राचा. तर मग त्या ज्योग्राफीमध्ये आपल्याला माहिती आहे बरेचसे प्रकार आहेत. फिजिकल ज्योग्राफी असेल, ह्युमन ज्योग्राफी असेल, ठीक आहे. तर त्यामध्ये हे सगळे इथं आपण उल्लेख केलेल्या ज्योग्राफीच्या ज्या प्रकारांमधले उत्तरं प्रश्न इथं विचारले जातील त्याचे योग्य उत्तरं तिथं द्यायचे आहेत. नंतर इंडियन पॉलिटिकल सिस्टम, आता भारताची राज्यव्यवस्था जी काय आहे तर त्यामध्ये ॲडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ऑफ सेंट्रल अँड स्टेट गव्हर्नमेंट, केंद्र आणि राज्य सरकारांचं ॲडमिनिस्ट्रेशन जे आहे त्या संदर्भातली माहिती, जिल्हा परिषदेचं ॲडमिनिस्ट्रेशन, तालुक्याच्या पंचायतीचं ॲडमिनिस्ट्रेशन, ग्रामपंचायतीचं ॲडमिनिस्ट्रेशन. नंतर रोल ऑफ पोलीस पाटील तलाठी इन द विलेज ॲडमिनिस्ट्रेशन. आता हा विषय जो आहे हा ॲग्रिकल्चरच्या संदर्भात आहे त्यामुळं रुरल इंडिया अभ्यासावा लागणार आहे. त्यापैकी पोलीस पाटील आणि तलाठी यांचा रोल इथं माहिती पाहिजे. सोशल रिफॉर्म्स इन महाराष्ट्र, सामाजिक सुधारणा चळवळींमधील आपले जे काही सोशल रिफॉर्मन्स होते, विचारवंत होते, समाजसुधारक होते त्यांचा आपल्याला इथं अभ्यास आवश्यक आहे महाराष्ट्राच्या संदर्भातला. उल्लेखनीय सर्व नावे आपल्याला राज्यसेवेच्या सिलेबसमध्ये बघायला मिळतील. त्यात त्या व्हिडिओमध्ये तुम्ही ते व्यवस्थित ती नावं बघू शकता. सिलेबसमध्ये पण आहे सगळ्यात. त्यानंतर इंडियन इकॉनॉमी, भारतीय अर्थव्यवस्था, रोल ऑफ ॲग्रिकल्चर इन इंडियन इकॉनॉमी म्हणजे आपल्या शेतीचा या सर्व देशाच्या अर्थव्यवस्थेमध्ये काय रोल आहे, इम्पॅक्ट ऑफ ग्लोबलायझेशन. ग्लोबलायझेशन म्हणजे जागतिकीकरण जे झालं आहे त्याचा ह्या इकॉनॉमीवर तसंच ॲग्रिकल्चरमध्ये जो इम्पॅक्ट आहे तो. त्यानंतर लिबरलायझेशन, उदारता जी काय आहे आपल्या ट्रेडमध्ये ती. त्यानंतर प्रायव्हेटायझेशन म्हणजे खाजगीकरण, उदात्तीकरण, खाजगीकरण आणि जागतिकीकरण या तीन गोष्टी ज्यांचा भारतीय अर्थव्यवस्थेवर काय परिणाम झाला. ग्लोबलायझेशन, लिबरलायझेशन अँड प्रायव्हेटायझेशन अँड देअर इम्पॅक्ट ऑन इंडियन इकॉनॉमी. त्यासाठी बातम्या वगैरे व्यवस्थित बघून आपल्याला त्याचं बरीचशी माहिती मिळू शकेल लगेचच्या लगेच जे चालू घडामोडीमध्ये आपण बघतो त्या. त्यानंतर सस्टेनेबल डेव्हलपमेंट, पोल्युशन, कन्झर्वेशन ऑफ नॅचरल रिसोर्सेस, सस्टेनेबल ॲग्रिकल्चर, दॅन सस्टेनेबल इंडस्ट्रीयल डेव्हलपमेंट, रोल ऑफ इंटरनॅशनल, नॅशनल, स्टेट लेवल एजन्सीज, ज्या काही संस्था आहेत देशातल्या, राज्यातल्या आणि आंतरराष्ट्रीय, अँड द एन जी ओज इन सस्टेनेबल डेव्हलपमेंट. त्यानंतर कम्प्युटर्स अँड इन्फॉर्मेशन टेक्नॉलॉजी. आता हा भाग रोजच्या आपल्या दळणवळणातला जो भाग आहे तो व्यवस्थित करायचा आहे. यूज ऑफ कम्प्युटर्स इन डिफरंट फील्ड्स, यू नो द कम्पोनंट्स, देर इम्पॉर्टंट टर्म्स अँड टर्मिनॉलॉजीज इन कम्प्युटर्स, देर हार्डवेअर, सॉफ्टवेअर, एव्हरीथिंग, इट्स स्कोप अँड लिमिटेशन्स. देन इन्फॉर्मेशन टेक्नॉलॉजी, आय टी म्हणतो आपण याला, त्यामध्ये इंटरनेट असेल, ईमेल असेल, ई कॉमर्स असेल, वेगवेगळे काही सॉफ्टवेअर्स असतील, त्यानंतर काही वेबसाईट्स असतील ज्या आपल्या ॲग्रिकल्चरच्या संदर्भात उपयोगात असतील, दोस वेबसाईट्स विच आर रिलेटेड विथ ॲग्रिकल्चर इन्फॉर्मेशन. देन इम्पॅक्ट ऑफ पॉलिटिकल, इकॉनॉमिकल, सोशल, कम्युनिकेशन, पब्लिक हेल्थ डेव्हलपमेंट्स ऑन रुरल लाईफ. आता ह्या सर्व काही ज्या गोष्टी केल्या जातात राजकीय आर्थिक, सामाजिक, त्यानंतर दळणवळणाच्या, लोकांच्या आरोग्यासंदर्भातल्या ज्या काही डेव्हलपमेंट्स आहेत त्याचा आपल्या रुरल किंवा ग्रामीण स्थितीवर किंवा परिस्थितीवर काय परिणाम होतो तो आपण इथं अभ्यासायचा आहे चांगल्यापैकी. देन द फोर्थ पार्ट, ॲग्रिकल्चर. दिस वन इज द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टंट दॅट वी सी. 25 क्वेश्चन्स विल बी दॅट ॲग्रिकल्चर. यू शुड से द लँड युटिलायझेशन अँड मेजर क्रॉप्स इन इंडिया ॲज वेल ॲज इन द स्टेट ऑफ महाराष्ट्र. देन इरिगेशन सोर्स अँड द मेथड्स. ॲनिमल हजबंड्री अँड डेअरी. हॉर्टिकल्चर, फॉरेस्ट डेव्हलपमेंट अँड प्रोड्यूस. फिशरीज, ॲग्रिकल्चरल इकॉनॉमिक्स. आता ॲग्रिकल्चर इकॉनॉमिक्स आणि नॅशनल इकॉनॉमिक्समध्ये बरंचसा साम्य आपल्याला बघायला मिळेल. तो अभ्यास चांगल्यापैकी होऊ शकतो. आणि मेजर क्रॉप्स, आता मेजर क्रॉप्समध्ये व्हॉट यू शूड डू. सर्व क्रॉप्स जे आहेत देशातले आणि राज्यातले, राज्यातले जास्त महत्त्वाचे आणखी त्यामध्ये थोडंसं जोर देऊन, आणि त्यामध्ये असलेल्या ज्या काही छोट्या छोट्या गोष्टी आहेत, काही व्हरायटीज किंवा काही नवीन प्रायव्हेट प्लेयर्सच्या पण व्हरायटीजचा इथं उल्लेख होऊ शकतो. तर ह्या व्हरायटीचे नाव माहिती पाहिजे, त्यांचे स्पेसिंग, त्यांचं सीड रेट, कदाचित त्यातले काही पेस्ट डिसीज, मॅनेजमेंट प्रॅक्टिसेस. ठीक आहे, तर हे झालं प्रिलिमिनरीच्या संदर्भात. आता जो मेन्सचा भाग आहे, आता एकदा सुरुवात प्री आपण क्लिअर झालो, त्यानंतर महाराष्ट्र कृषी सेवा मुख्य परीक्षेसाठी जो दुसरा टप्पा असेल आपला, तर तो लेखी परीक्षा 400 मार्क्सची होणार. आणि त्यानंतर मुख्य परीक्षेनंतर क्लिअर झाल्यानंतर 50 गुणांची मुलाखत घेतली जाणार. आता यामध्ये दोन प्रश्नपत्रिका म्हणजे दोन विषय असणार आहेत. अगोदर फक्त एकच प्रश्नपत्रिका प्रीला, मेन्सला दोन प्रश्नपत्रिका, त्यामध्ये एक अनिवार्य आणि एक वैकल्पिक. आता आपल्याला माहिती आहे ॲग्रिकल्चर सेक्टरमध्ये ॲग्रिकल्चर सायन्स आहे. त्यानंतर इथं दोन क्वेश्चन पेपर हे जे वैकल्पिकमध्ये आपण बघतोय, ती असेल ॲग्रिकल्चरची आणि दुसरी आहे ॲग्रिकल्चर इंजिनिअरिंगची. ठीक आहे, तर पेपर क्रमांक एक तो अनिवार्य म्हणजे कंपल्सरी, किंवा तुमचा दोन्ही पण जे आहेत ॲग्रीचे आणि ॲग्रिकल्चरल इंजिनिअरिंगचे विद्यार्थी यांना कॉमन ही प्रश्नपत्रिका असणार आहे. संकेतांक 015. ठीक आहे, कृषी विज्ञान विषय संकेतांक, त्याच्यात प्रश्न असतील 100 गुण त्याचे 200, म्हणजे 2 मार्कांना एक प्रश्न. माध्यम इंग्लिश दोन्हीचा पण राहील. ठीक आहे, आणि कालावधी दोन्हींना एक एक तास. आणि दर्जा कृषी पदवी हे कॉमन कृषी विज्ञानमध्ये कृषी पदवी दर्जा राहील, तुमची ॲग्रिकल्चर अँड अलाइड सायन्सेसची डिग्री. आणि जो वैकल्पिक विषय आहे तर त्यामध्ये ॲग्रिकल्चर अँड अलाइडमध्ये कृषीचा विषय राहील आणि ॲग्रिकल्चर इंजिनिअरिंगमध्ये इंजिनिअरिंगचे प्रश्न असतील. आणि त्याचं त्या पदवीच्या समकक्ष त्यात प्रश्न विचारले जातील. आणि दोन्ही प्रश्नपत्रिकांचं स्वरूप वस्तुनिष्ठ बहुपर्यायी राहील. आता वैकल्पिक विषय कृषीचा 101 अथवा कृषी अभियांत्रिकी ॲग्रिकल्चर इंजिनिअरिंग या दोन विषयापैकी कोणताही एक विषय निवडावा आपल्या डिग्रीनुसार. म्हणजे जर BSc ॲग्री किंवा त्यातच सम इतर डिग्रीज असतील, ॲलाइड हॉर्टिकल्चर असेल, तर त्यामध्ये कृषीचा विषय राहील. आणि ॲग्रिकल्चर इंजिनिअरिंग डिग्री जर झालेली असेल तर कृषी अभियांत्रिकी यापैकी एक विषय निवडायचा आहे. आता सविस्तर अभ्यासक्रम याचा बघू आपण. सर्व आपल्या नजरेखालून गेलेलंच आहे. पूर्वी सर्व आपल्याला पुस्तकं, जुनं जे काही आपलं स्टडी मटेरियल आहे डिग्रीमधलं पूर्ण, तर त्यामध्ये जे काही उल्लेख झालेला आहे तो सर्वच्या सर्व अभ्यासक्रम इथं आपल्या नजरेखालून गेला पाहिजेच. हे महत्त्वाचं आहे. सविस्तर अभ्यासक्रमामध्ये पेपर 1 जो कंपल्सरी आहे त्यामध्ये ॲग्रिकल्चर सायन्स प्रश्नपत्रिका किंवा त्याचा जो कोड नंबर आहे तो आहे 015015. नाउ द स्टँडर्ड ऑफ दिस एक्झाम इट विल बी डिग्री इन ॲग्री ऑर ॲग्रिकल्चर इंजिनिअरिंग. सो ग्रॅज्युएशन इज रिक्वायर्ड. मार्क्स आर 200. नेचर ऑफ पेपर ऑब्जेक्टिव टाईप. एंड टोटल नंबर ऑफ क्वेश्चन 100. सो ईच क्वेश्चन फॉर 2 मार्क्स, 200 मार्क्स, ड्यूरेशन फॉर ऑफ 1 आवर, एंड द एग्जाम विल बी इन इंग्लिश एज यू हैव लर्न और एज यू हैव स्टडीड योर डिग्री इन इंग्लिश. एवरीथिंग विल बी इन इंग्लिश, सो नीड नॉट टू वरी अबाउट दैट, बिकॉज द टर्म्स इन इंग्लिश एंड मराठी दे मे चेंज ड्रास्टिकली. सो वट एवर यू हैव लर्न इन योर डिग्री प्रोग्राम दैट विल बी फॉर योर पेपर. नाउ देर आर सेक्शंस, फर्स्ट ऑफ एग्रोनॉमी, सेकंड ऑफ योर सॉइल साइंस एंड एग्रीकल्चर केमिस्ट्री, एंड थर्ड एग्रीकल्चरल इंजीनियरिंग इन पेपर 1. एग्रोनॉमी, सॉइल साइंस एंड एग्रीकल्चरल केमिस्ट्री एंड एग्रीकल्चरल इंजीनियरिंग इन योर पेपर 1. एंड द रेस्ट ऑफ द सब्जेक्ट्स ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर अदर देन दीज 3 सब्जेक्ट्स दे विल बी हैविंग देयर शेयर इन पेपर 2. ओके, इन नेक्स्ट पेपर मीन्स द सेकंड पेपर इन एग्रीकल्चर, एग्रीकल्चर दैट स्ट्रीम पेपर. ओके, देन एग्रोनॉमी द मार्क्स अलॉटेड आर 80, 80 मार्कांसाठी पेपर. फर्स्ट विल स्टार्ट विथ प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ एग्रोनॉमी. Actually, what agronomy is, all of you are knowing the definition, the scope, role of agronomists in agriculture. Many books, they are good at explaining this. Then, classification of crops. Now, agriculture seasons in India and in Maharashtra. Factors affecting the crop production. This is about your distribution of crops at each place, each geographical identification, or you may say geographical differentiation, has different crops, so you have to classify the crops according to that area. Then tillage, factors affecting tillage. Then types of tillage operations, tillage implements, effects of tillage on soil and crop growth. And at last, modern concepts of tillage. So all these things, they fall in agronomy also, and most of the things by simultaneously they will be studied in agriculture engineering also. So need not science also, you will get the issues means cleared for the purpose of better understanding. Again, regarding the seed, this will be from the seed science, the qualities of good seed, types of seed, seed testing and seed treatment. Then the different methods of sowing, optimum plant population and geometry, and classification of seeds. Now different types, what the classification is based upon their there is a type and there is a classification. Okay, so differentiate this properly. Then cropping systems, so types of cropping systems, crop rotations, relay cropping, mix cropping, and whatever what you know, cropping patterns and cropping systems, you should understand and you should write it. The questions will be based upon this, means syllabus is just to give you the outline of that particular topic, which should be analyzed first, and then only you are getting the answer right there, means as per analysis only you should do it. नाहीतर काय घडतं, फक्त मुद्देसूद, याच्यामध्ये मुद्देसूद नसतं, प्रत्येक पॉईंटवर इथं अभ्यास करावा लागतो, इथं त्याचं एक ॲनालिसिस करून त्याचं कन्क्लुजन काढावं लागतं, आणि मग ते सांगितलं जातं. 3-4 केसेस तुमच्या समोर ठेवले जातील, आणि त्या 3-4 केसेसपैकी काय योग्य आहे, जे सगळ्यात योग्य आहे तेच उत्तर तुमचं राहील. सो नेक्स्ट पार्ट इन ॲग्रोनॉमी रिगार्डिंग वीड्स, इट्स डेफिनेशन, देन द मेथड्स ऑफ वीड कंट्रोल, इंटिग्रेटेड वीड मॅनेजमेंट concept, IWM, that you should follow. Next is agricultural metrology. So the Indian agriculture is based upon the climate, or you may say the conditions of weather, that we should analyze, and then only we should have our activities in farming or in agriculture. Now definition of metrology, weather and climate elements of the weather, temperature measurement, all the instruments, then factors affecting temperature, the solar radiation, significance of solar radiation in agriculture, what is the use of sun's rays, then फैक्टर्स अफेक्टिंग सोलर रेडिएशन, मेजरमेंट ऑफ सोलर रेडिएशन मीन्स हाउ यू आर मेजरिंग इट, आइदर द नेम्स ऑफ द रिकॉर्डिंग एंड नॉन रिकॉर्डिंग टाइप ऑफ इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स यू शुड हैव, देन एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर, टेम्परेचर, सोलर रेडिएशन, एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर इट्स मेजरमेंट, वेरिएशन ऑफ प्रेशर विथ हाइट, हाइड्रोलॉजिकल साइकिल, हाइड्रो और योर वट एवर द हाइड्रोस्फेयर इज हैविंग दिस टोटल साइकिल, एंड इफ सम थिंग्स गो बैड इट इज अ ड्रॉट, सो यू शुड स्टडी द ड्रॉट क्लाइमेटोलॉजी. देन क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ ड्रॉट, वट टाइप्स ऑफ ड्रॉट्स दे आर, एंड वेदर फोरकास्टिंग विच इज इम्पॉर्टेंट इन एग्रीकल्चर, इट्स क्लासिफिकेशन टाइप्स मीडियम, शॉर्ट, लॉन्ग और समथिंग एल्स दैट वी कैन फॉलो नाउ. देन टेक्निक्स ऑफ वेदर फोरकास्टिंग, फोरकास्टिंग नेटवर्क इन इंडिया, एडवांस वंस. नाउ द सिलेबस मे गेट सम वॉट एडिशंस अगेन एज पर द न्यू न्यू एडवांसेस इन द डिफरेंट कोर्सेस. देन इरीगेशन वाटर मैनेजमेंट, सॉइल वाटर इरीगेशन एंड ड्रेनेज, दीज थ्री फैक्टर्स यू हैव टू स्टडी वेरी वेरी वेल बिकॉज दे विल बी द कंपोनेंट ऑफ योर एग्रोनॉमी एज वेल एज योर इंजीनियरिंग. सो द सोर्सेस मीन्स रिगार्डिंग द सॉइल वाटर, सोर्सेस ऑफ वाटर, एब्सॉर्प्शन एंड मूवमेंट ऑफ वाटर इन सॉइल, सॉइल मॉइस्चर कॉन्स्टेंट्स, देन फॉर्म्स ऑफ सॉइल वाटर, फैक्टर्स अफेक्टिंग अवेलेबल सॉइल मॉइस्चर, एब्सॉर्प्शन ऑफ सॉइल मॉइस्चर बाय द प्लांट्स, फैक्टर्स अफेक्टिंग एब्सॉर्प्शन, इवेपोरेशन, ट्रांसपिरेशन, कंजम्पटिव यूज एंड इफेक्टिव रेनफॉल. नेक्स्ट पार्ट इज रिगार्डिंग द इरीगेशन. Now you have to work out, maybe some calculations should be done quickly there regarding water requirement, irrigation requirement of crops, factors affecting water requirement, scheduling of in this irrigation, the approaches that are used for that scheduling, then depth of irrigation, measurement of irrigation and water use efficiency, the formulae and your calculations. There may be a problem asked. Then regarding drainage, importance of drainage, types of drainage, effect of bad drainage on the soil and crop growth. Then field crops, kharif crops including forages, cereals, millets and pulses. Now here I won't tell regarding all these things, we'll just go forward with their importance, soil and climatic requirement, varieties, seed and sowing. These points you are learning while you are studying your crop production, manures and fertilizers, application schedule, types of application methods and all, water and irrigation needs, management of weeds, weed management as you have seen it early in the weeds, then plant protection measures for healthy crop, then crop rotation, cropping systems, harvesting, yield and production potential of that crop, and seed production, the most important thing. Now what the components will be in the crops, you may classify them as cereals and millets, the list is given, the pulses, the list of pulses is given which will be asked, then the oil seeds, fiber crops, commercial crops, forage crops and green manuring crops. So regarding these, all these crops, the questions will be asked as per the weightage and a proper understanding should be there what you are to answer actually. Is the optimum answer after interpretation should be given. Then this was regarding the kharif crops. Okay, all these crops, they are kharif crops. Again in case of rabi crops, these things means earlier things, they are common. You should write the importance, history, distribution, production, growth pattern and critical stages etc., everything about them, and the list of these crops which are grown in rabi, the cereals, the pulses, oil seeds, commercial crops, forage crops, summer crops at the last. Then rain fed agriculture, this one is the most important in case of geographical distribution, agroclimatic zones of Maharashtra, techniques of soil and water conservation, this will be part of engineering also, the moisture conservation, crop residue management, mulches, minimum tillage and zero tillage, harvesting and recycling of runoff water, drought resistant crops, contingency planning in case of crop failures in rain fed agriculture. You should know the definition of rain fed agriculture first, before starting the study of related agriculture and these components. The next is farming system and sustainable agriculture. So what is farming system, what is sustainable agriculture, the definitions, sustainable agriculture, resource management, components of farming system, and effect of preceding and associated crops. So we people are having many crops in series or in sequence, but as and when these crops are in the field, what actually their attachment is, means the preceding crop is having some effect on the succeeding crop, or they may have effect on each other, where they are commonly, or you may say if they are in intercrop mode or in as a mixed crop. So farming system and sustainable agriculture should be studied in this manner. So this was your agronomy, don't be fooled by the short size of the syllabus, it's too vast. Okay, so keep this in mind and revise it properly again and again. The next is soil science. Now in soil science, the basic soil science is there. Also don't get fooled by such a short, some 10 or 11 lines of your syllabus. Here it's a big part, definition of soil, weathering of rocks and minerals, physical and chemical properties of soil, soil structure, its definition, types and its importance in crop production, soil texture, the classes of soil texture, the ion exchange, soil solution, organic matter, soil moisture, alkaline and acid soils, their properties, and there may be some tricky questions in soil science regarding all the components or the soil properties, the quality of irrigation water, the soil survey, soil fertility and soil productivity, differentiation may be there. Then soil water movement, as we have seen in the agronomy part, irrigation, infiltration, soil and water movement, percolation, evaporation, the definitions and their explanations will be there, evapotranspirations, some instruments, the names should be there, as in the case of agrometrology, the essential plant nutrients, this is the main part, organic manures, then fertilizers, integrated nutrient management, the INM in case of integrated crop management, this is important. Then eco-friendly farming, without means the chemicals, they should be used in eco-friendly manner. Then nutrient management in the problem soils, so you should know first the problem soils in India as well as Maharashtra, and you should design the nutrient management, know about the nutrient management, the questions will be answered properly. Preparation of compost, vermicompost, and the types of compost, composting methods you should know, organic farming, the merits and demerits of organic farming, mixed, complex and compound fertilizers, their merits and demerits also, then micronutrients, liquid fertilizers, biofertilizer, soil pollution by agrochemicals. So the pollution that we are witnessing due to activities in agriculture, due to indiscriminate use of chemicals, agrochemicals like fertilizers, in other inputs like plant protection chemicals, so they should be studied, and what the activities are done actually against them to conserve the environment, or the precautions taken, they are also to be studied, and then you can answer these questions very nicely. The marks will be 40 for soil science and agricultural chemistry. Then the third part, this one is major, 80 marks are issued here, means 80 marks for agriculture engineering, 80 marks for agronomy, and here 40 marks for soil science. Now what will be there in agricultural engineering topic or the syllabus here? The farm machinery and power, sources of farm power, so you have all these things in a single course regarding farm power, and you have to keep a comparison of all these human, animal and mechanical power sources. You should study the engines, their cycles, their working principles, okay, and all whole of their components. The next thing in farm machinery and power is tillage. So tillage, you'll know the topic beyond your understanding other than agronomy, its definition, function, classification, primary, secondary implements,
and all the types of systems for their hitching in mechanical as well as animal drawn implements. Then seed cum fertilizer drill, metering mechanism, planters, chaff cutters, means all the machinery that we are utilizing, the harvesters, threshers, sickers, mowers, reapers and combines. Then plant protection equipment, the types of sprayers and dusters, principle of operation, uses, and this may be studied in entomology also. Then the agriculture process engineering, farm machinery and power is there, and next is agriculture process engineering. Now the changes occurring in food grains during storage, so storage structures we have to know, their capacities, their style of preparation and all, who prepared it, likewise the pre-cooling definition and types, freezing, cooling, these mechanisms we should know, refrigeration, their principles behind it, compression refrigeration system, cold storage, its meaning and use for agriculture process engineering. The next is determination of moisture content, direct indirect methods, we have learned this in soil science also. Then working principle of agricultural machineries, you may say milk, grain and fruits, processing equipments, grinders, mill grades, cleaners, separators and seed treaters. Then material handling equipments, you know, the belt, bucket and screw conveyors, types of conveyors, materials for packaging of agriculture and horticultural produce. Next part, soil and water conservation. Now this is somewhat mixed again. So principles of watershed management, this is in your first syllabus. Then what is watershed, surveying leveling, types of survey, objects of surveying, survey instruments, then the measurements of distances, okay, and area, chain compass surveying, so this is part of survey. Then watershed characteristics, rainfall patterns, and you may have some problems here regarding, problems means some calculations you have to make and you have to write the answer. So peak runoff rate and everything, your evaporation, evapotranspiration, infiltration, those things may be asked. Then soil and water conservation structures that are used in Maharashtra for water harvesting as well as the farm pond, some problem may be asked. Again, erosion control, all the methods, biological and engineering measures, here you say the conservation structures are there. Then principles of watershed management is there. Then micro irrigation and drainage engineering. First of all, concept of micro irrigation, you have to depict types of micro irrigation, then their design, the pump selection, whole of your designing, okay, micro irrigation, your drip and other things. Then farm structures, so in case of building materials, location and management of farm steel, silo pit and trench silo, these are post harvest ones. Then farm fencing, greenhouses, and again all of these things you have to write. There may be some calculations, there may be some numerical workout that you should do by knowing the formulae, so keep this in mind regarding all these components in the farm structures part of your agricultural engineering in paper 1 of agricultural MPSC mains. Now regarding paper 2, in paper 2 this is optional subject, this is agriculture. Now so for the people who have taken part or taken their degree in agriculture or allied sciences other than agricultural engineering, they are going to opt for this paper. So the standard is degree, 100 questions, 200 marks, English medium of answering, and questions will be of objective type, and those 100 questions you should solve in 1 hour. So calculate the time that you have in your hand, means 60 minutes and 100 questions. So this is a limiting factor. Your planning should be good, means more than double you have the number of questions, almost double, okay, means half a minute or not even a minute for each of your question to be answered. So think this, keep it in mind and plan accordingly. So you need less than a minute to solve the questions. Now all of these things, the syllabus, first is agriculture botany, 40 marks weightage. You need to say the morphology of plants, the anatomy of the plants, the cytogenetics and the genetics, major genetics, the Mendelian genetics will be there. Then second part will be plant breeding. Now here the methods of breeding, all the breeding methods you have to write along with the genetic engineering also, and whatever the new techniques are, they will also be incorporated in the plant breeding section. The third thing is plant physiology, whole of the physiology, the osmosis, transpiration, rot, the different cycles that you learn in whole of your plant sciences, C3, C4, CAM plants, respiration, photorespiration, and other things like photoperiodism, vernalization, then regarding the these hormones, PGRs, plant growth regulation hormones. Then social forestry, you know about silviculture, agroforestry and their importance and scope, medicinal and aromatic plants. Then environmental science and agroecology. Now in agroecology, its definition, this is a whole of the environmental science, pollution, you need to explain the agro ecosystem. Next, biotechnology in plant science, plant biotechnology, all the cultural techniques, their definitions, their components, the points are there, you are acquainted with all these things, and along with that some applications of this plant biotechnology in biopesticides, that is the need of the time for organic farming, biofertilizers is the are to be utilized, then cryopreservation means the preservation in negative temperature component, that you may say in liquid nitrogen at minus 196 degrees Celsius, secondary metabolites that have been generated through biotechnology. So these are all things that you should study in case of plant science, that is your botany section for 40 marks. Now plant protection, so these two sections of entomology and plant pathology, which are interrelated, they will carry half of this 40 marks schedule, 40 marks share. So general morphology, the morphology, anatomy and physiology of insects, their classification means the systematics part, and accordingly you should also go for the major pests and diseases in pathology also in all the crops that have been studied earlier, okay, in agronomy also. You know that you are studying the crops in the agronomy, so you should know the pests and diseases of those crops in detail. Then simple things are there, occurrence, life history, damage and control measures. Now the insecticides, their classification and formulations are there, and regarding beneficial insects, they are productive insects, you should have a deep understanding about these insects also and what are the recent happenings, the outbreaks of insects, their causes, this is about your ecology of insects, okay, insect ecology part is there, and accordingly you will have the IPM things to be utilized here. Then appliances in the plant protection, so the appliances, whatever you are using, those appliances will also be learned properly, means in depth, in the section of agriculture engineering that I have told earlier. The next thing is safe handling of pesticides, the antidotes for pesticide poisoning. Now these two things, you handle it safely, or if in case poisoning is there, what are the antidotes used, keep the knowledge of regarding this. Then pest management, what you have in pest management, earlier you have the knowledge of major insect pests of the field and horticultural crops, but here in pest management you'll find the pest resistance and role of biotechnology in pest management, different technologies like biopesticides, what are developed by biotech. Then study of non-insect pests, and the names are given like the snail, maybe some other organisms, and also keep the knowledge regarding the export, that is the phytosanitary certification, phytosanitary measures and all other sanitary measures which are utilized for keeping away the non-insect pests in the field as well as storage. Then residual effect of insecticides, its testing, national and international standards, and maybe its bad effects, you should also know regarding agrochemicals in sustainable agriculture as well as integrated pest management, and biological control of insect pests. As earlier told, biopesticides are there. You should know the definition, their utilization, and the new methods you may utilize or you may have the knowledge regarding the attractants, repellents, pheromones, light traps, and the specialized chemicals. They are the chemosterilants. The next half part, plant pathology, 20 marks will be there. You should know regarding the history and development of plant pathology, the importance of diseases and their position and structure, okay, in the whole of this world, you may generally say, and in special reference to agriculture, you should know the basic or the important microbes like the fungus, the bacteria, the viruses and mycoplasma, their reproduction methods and how they get the nutrition from the plant, their life cycle also you should study well. Their broad classification should be also known. Studies and economic importance of the referred ones, I won't refer all these things. Then dissemination and transmission of these disease causing organisms, that is, they are also called as pathogens. Then epidemiology and forecasting of these diseases and the disease resistance, symptomatology or symptomology. Then flowering parasites that we have, flowering parasites that are dependent, there may be semi or complete parasites. Then physiological disorders, physiological disorders of that plant itself, maybe some biotic, and in case of soil science you have to learn about abiotic disorders. Then principles of plant disease and its control, chemical biocontrol, the formulation and doses, the symptoms, the causal organisms, etiology and control measures of the diseases which are referred here, you should know. So the crops that you are studying in agronomy, you should know regarding the diseases. I won't name the diseases, I will just tell the crops: cotton, sorghum, groundnut, wheat, citrus, banana, sugarcane, grape, chili, turmeric, ginger, onion, vegetables, paddy, pigeon pea, green gram and black gram, soybean, sunflower, flower crops, in maybe protected also, protected flower crops, potato, linseed and sunflower. Next part is horticulture. Now those crops in horticulture which you are studying, they will also face the problems of plant protection. So in time you should study the horticulture crops with all respect, along with soil science also, there are plant protection also, harvest, post harvest, everything, mechanization and all. So cultivation of crops, so I won't refer the names now, everything is to be done regarding the total number of crops or horticulture crops that are referred here. Then the cultivation of vegetables, the fruits, that is your pomology, vegetables, the olericulture, and flowers, the floriculture. You should study well and accordingly you should analyze it and write in the paper. Then plant growth regulators and their uses. Now this is very important part. You should know the plant growth regulators, their names, general names, you may get some typical names also, their functions as per their PPM, how much it should be used and what the actual function they do in that particular plant, maybe in fruiting, maybe in flowering, maybe in production of vegetables, and along with that they are also to be utilized in weed management also. So you know the plant growth regulators, how they are utilized. Then post harvest management and processing, this one I have told earlier, so you should know regarding the post harvesting, or their first of all you should know the indices of harvesting or maturity indices. Then preparing all these foods, processed foods out of these horticultural products, horticultural crops. Then export import of horticulture crops, the units or the agencies which are related with it, that falls under economics, but you should know it for horticulture again. Then agricultural extension, so सो रूरल सोशियोलॉजी एंड कम्युनिटी डेवलपमेंट होल ऑफ द कोर्स दैट यू हैव विल यूटिलाइज इट यू स्टडी इट प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ एक्सटेंशन एजुकेशन एंड एजुकेशनल साइकोलॉजी देन एक्सटेंशन टीचिंग मेथड्स एंड ऑल ऑफ द टीचिंग एड्स दैट यू नो एंड इन दिस एरा वी आर going towards information technology and there is a interaction of people through digital media only then extension administration and program evaluation so extension administration meaning need scope there are basic principles of administration its organization everything you should find it properly analyze it and write it and characteristics of sound program and its implementation what techniques they are utilizing for whole of this extension activity to get some technology adopted by the farmers or the people in the society next part is agricultural economics so whole of the meaning definition consumption production all these factors we have to study then there are two parts first is agricultural economics and also farm management Here in agriculture economics, the basic principles we have to know the history. In case of economics, we have to learn on the part on the behalf of the central and state government what the activities they are done. Then problems of agriculture marketing, and along with the marketing types of markets and the institutes or you may say the functional bodies types of markets. Okay, regarding some specialized crops. International role, international organizations, then agriculture credit. All of you are acquainted with this from the some banking institutions. Agriculture credit is the most provided and cooperative sector which is involved in agriculture credit. Along with that, the problems which the farming community is having for this credit purpose. Then farm management and production economics all the basic rules laws you have to calculate then these budgeting you should know farm records and the most important the factor and product relationships these will be the formulae then at last the crop insurance now animal husbandry and dairy 20 marks in which and dairy will have half of it you should know the breeds then the farming and management activities that are followed in the farm management or animal husbandry then the breeding of animals you should also know the Mendelian genetics as well as animal genetics that you have right away then the reproduction means whole of the anatomy and physiology of the reproductive systems of the cattle and all the organisms that you have them in question or in your study and this MOET technology okay multiple ovulation and embryo transfer technology and the advances in it then the nutrition of animals that the ration the feed and ration that we are providing to the animals their calculations their functions in nutrition everything and improvement of the poor quality roughage uromol UAMB this urea molasses blocks what they are fed and the quality control of the feed as well as feed additives probiotics enzymes etc and the next part in dairying is regarding milk and milk products what means dairy means in your animal husbandry you are having your animals protected and here you are getting the production out of the animals or dairy products you may say the milk and milk products so milk and milk product the production and utilization their processing and before that you should know the anatomy physiology of mammary glands the theories of milk secretion etc and later on what the processes they are followed in case of dairy so how the production is to be taken which should be clean and hygienic then its transport processing packaging its pasteurization homogenization sterilization and cooling etc then important products their names you are also having with you their qualities or what the standards they have, they should also be referred, and marketing of milk products. So all of these things you will get firm knowledge through the white revolution evolution. Then legal standard and quality control tests regarding the milks. So aseptic packaging of milk and milk products, detection of common adulterants, nutritive value of milk, role of NDDB, IDC, that is Indian Dairy Corporation, and public and cooperative sectors, and dairy in progress of dairy industry. So here this will be the historical part as well as the contemporary part. And the last one in agriculture, food science, the weightage is 10 marks. So all of these things, this will also fall in your horticulture also, your dairy science also, dairy science means animal science and dairy science, production from animals, and earlier part through means whatever the production that we have taken from agronomy and horticulture, their processing, and at last its consumption. And with that you should keep the knowledge of packaging materials, then food additives, colors, natural and synthetic, flavors, discoloration or the problems that have arisen, and rancidities, then the food residues and byproducts, and new food products and development, food transportation, marketing and economics, wherein you will also get to know the packaging material and all, means whole of the processing industry, how it functions or what does it need, will be in your food science. So this was all about your agricultural paper in agricultural MPSC. And the paper 2 means this optional paper of agriculture engineering, we'll just refer this what common things that you can see from agriculture and what are the different things. So in paper 2 of optional, it is code 102, so it is having the requirement of degree in agriculture engineering, English medium, objective type, 100 questions, 200 marks and 60 minutes. So farm power and farm machinery, this you have referred earlier, farm power, and this will be for the degree program of BTech, or you may say the agriculture engineering. So to refer it in short, farm power, then agriculture tractors, whole of the things in detail regarding agriculture tractors, then tillage machinery that we have seen earlier, and planting and harvesting machinery, then plant protection appliances that we have earlier in our entomology also, and engineering paper also. Then agricultural process engineering, now drying of farm crops, so whatever the theories are, they should be utilized. Then handling of agriculture material, some equipments and implements are there, machineries are there. Then processing of agriculture and horticulture products for cleaning, sorting, and whatever the processes that they are done on agriculture and horticulture products, including dairy and food materials. Okay, dairy engineering you may call it, the unit operations in food processing, mass and energy balancer, whatever the, these things, they are in detail. Then electrical and other energy resources for 20 marks, electricity, solar energy, wind energy, then biomass energy. So this is all about your energy resources and the basic principles underlying them, their calculations, their functionings and basic theories. Then farm structures, so engineering properties of materials of construction, load bearing capacity of soil, and everything what you have seen in farm structures in engineering paper. Then soil and water conservation engineering for 60 marks, you should know the hydrology, the sedimentation, then the soil erosion, watershed management, concept of watershed management and everything, you have to calculate the waterways, runaways, whatever the flooding is there, okay, drainage, erosion, etc. Then irrigation and drainage engineering, fluid mechanics, irrigation methods that they have, then canal irrigation, terms in this irrigation, everything, then drainage engineering, groundwater hydrology, there are some laws regarding this hydrology, and land development. So all these things they have been referred by the Maharashtra Public Service Commission, and this should be your main focus while you are in your degree program, that whatever you are studying at this moment in your degree program will benefit you at or till the last moment. Means your degree is carrying the energy for success, and if you attempt these exams while you are having your whole life cycle going on and you are studying properly since the first year as you have entered the college up till the last, if you are doing it consistently, if you are studying consistently, success is guaranteed. So all of you agriculture, or you may say simply the agricos, all the best for your preparations and success to you. Thank you.